Right. Sometimes, depending on how much solder is at one of the points you want to solder, you might not need to get any more solder from your coil. Sometimes there's enough solder from your tinned wire and from that point itself to make that joint, and that's good. I mean, you want to, you know, when you're dealing with the actual circuit board, you want to maybe kind of refrain from putting too much new solder on it, just because, you know, if you haven't had a lot of experience with it, sometimes you can get just a lot of sloppy kind of blobs of solder that conduct electricity where you don't want them to be, and if you make mistakes, it's hard to correct. So in this case, I've got a little bit extra solder. I've kind of got it on the tip of my wire here. It's already kind of hardened up. I'm going to put my wire kind of where I want it, right here on the circuit board, and apply heat here with the iron. And it doesn't take much. It just takes like a couple seconds. And once it flows, just sort of let go. You know, once you kind of see that solder get liquid, pull the iron away. And so there we go. So now we have one joint made. We can test it with the alligator clip. So that is to say, let's put one of the clips on the other part of that switch here, right? One of the other outside terminals. And we'll flick that switch in the center position. Turn the little guy on here. There we go.
Hello. Cow. Which animal says?
Okay, so it's in the off position. It's not having an effect here. There we go. Now let's put it in. Put it in one of the two positions.
Cow. Which animal says?
There we go. Good. So what we know now is that that's a good joint. We've got that common contact in the center of the switch gone to the place we want. Now all we have to do is install those other two wires. So anytime we flick that switch, we'll get this circuit kind of launching into those really cool looping behaviors.